Let us pray.
Ẹjẹ́ kí a gbàdúrà.
Our great God in heaven, we thank you for your great revelation in your word, which you bring to our hearts every time we come together.
Ọlọ́run wa tí ó ga jùlọ, Ọlọ́run, a dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ yín fún ìfihàn, ilé tí ẹ fi hàn fún wa nínú ọ̀rọ̀ yín ní gbogbo ìgbà tí a bá péjọpọ̀ níwájú
yín. We thank you because of the depth and the height of the revelation in your word.
A dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ yín fún jíjìn àti gíga ìfihàn ọ̀rọ̀ yín náà.
We thank you because only your spirit can make us to know how profound your word is.
A dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ yín torí pa mọ̀ pé ẹ̀mí yín nìkan so oló lè jẹ́ kí a mọ bí ọ̀rọ̀ yín ṣe ní ipa àti agbára tó.
We pray that as we look at the supremacy and the excellency of Christ once again tonight, you will lift our hearts to really understand and help us by experience and by life to exalt Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
Olúwa ń gbàdúrà pé bí a ṣe tún máa wo bí Kristi Olúwa wá ṣe gbópọn tí ó sì jẹ ọlọ́nlá tó ní àṣálẹ̀ nípasẹ̀ ọ̀rọ̀ yín, wípé kí ẹ̀mí yín kí ó ràn wá lọ́wọ́ láti lè máa fi ògo ìyìn àti ọlá fún Kristi náà.
We pray, O Lord, that you help us as we read the word, search the word, meditate on the word, that will understand the truth you are revealing to every one of us.
Olúwa ń gbàdúrà pé bí a ti ń ṣe àyẹ̀wò ọ̀rọ̀ yín tí a ń ṣe àwárí nínú ọ̀rọ̀ yín tí a sì ń ṣàṣàrò nínú ọ̀rọ̀ náà, pé kí ẹ̀mí yín kí ó lè mú kí ọ̀rọ̀ náà kó gbilẹ̀ nínú ayé
wa. And we pray that as we come and hear, we'll be growing more and more like Christ in Jesus' name.
Pé bí a ti ń wá láti wá máa kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ nínú ọ̀rọ̀ náà, a ó lè máa dàgbà sí nígbà gbogbo bíi ti Kristi ní orúkọ Jésù.
Thank you for the answer, dear Lord.
A dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ yín torí pé ẹ ti dáhùn àdúrà wo lu ọ̀wọ́.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Ní orúkọ Jésù ni a gbàdúrà.
We come once again to study the word of God together.
A wá lẹ́ẹ̀kan sí i láti kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run papọ̀.
You will see as we are going through the epistle to the Hebrews that actually we have some very important teachings of the word of God contained in this epistle.
Ó rí wípé bí a ti ń kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ nínú èpístélì sí àwọn ará Hebrew yìí, bẹ́ẹ̀ la rí àwọn ẹ̀kọ́ tó ṣe pàtàkì tí ó wà nínú èpístélì náà.
There are things that if you read personally on your own, you may not fully understand.
Àwọn nǹkan kan wà tó jẹ́ pé tó bá jẹ́ pé ìwọ ló dá kà fúnra ara rẹ ni o lè mọ lóye rẹ̀.
You may understand superficially, you may not be able to get into the depth and the height of the revelation of God for us.
O kàn lè lóye rẹ̀ ní òfe igi lásán, ṣùgbọ́n kí o má lè lọ jinlẹ̀ nínú ìfihàn tí ń bẹ nínú ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run.
That's the privilege we have as a church coming together so that we can study together.
Àǹfààní tá a wá nínú gẹ́gẹ́ bí ìjọ tí à ń wá papọ̀ tí a sì ń kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ papọ̀.
The word of God is very deep indeed.
Ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run ó jìn lọ́pọ̀lọpọ̀.
There are some things as a single believer you may be able to gather from the surface when you survey it, you study it, you try to understand it personally yourself.
Àwọn nǹkan kan wà tí o lè lóye rẹ̀ lófege gẹ́gẹ́ bí onígbàgbọ́ àdánìkan tó jẹ́ pé ń gbò bá kà o kàn lè lóye díẹ̀ nípa ẹ̀.
But as it is in various things in life, until you dig deep into the word, you may not be able to get the treasure that the Lord has hidden for us in the word of God.
Ṣùgbọ́n gẹ́gẹ́ bí o ṣe máa ń rí nínú ayé yìí pé láì jẹ́ pé èèyàn bá wa lẹ̀ jìn, irú ẹni bẹ́ẹ̀ ò ní lè mọ àwọn ohun tí ó jinlẹ̀, àwọn ohun iyebíye tí Ọlọ́run fi pamọ́ nínú ọ̀rọ̀ rẹ̀ náà.
And so that's why we come together.
Ìdí tí a fi ń wá papọ̀ nìyí.
And we bless the name of the Lord for the love and the interest he has given every one of us coming together like this every Monday to study the word of God.
A sì fi ìbùkún fún orúkọ Ọlọ́run, ẹni tí ó fi irú ìfẹ́ bẹ́ẹ̀ sínú ọkàn olúkúlùkù àwa tí à ń wá ní ọjọ́ ajé báyìí láti wá kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ ọ̀rọ̀.
We are already in Hebrews chapter 7.
A wà nínú ìwé Hebrew orí keje.
And we're looking at verses 11 to 19 today.
A sì máa wo ẹsẹ̀ ìkọkànlá sí ẹsẹ̀ ìkọkàndínlógún lónìí.
Please open your Bible with me as we read together.
Jọ̀wọ́ sí Bíbélì rẹ pẹ̀lú mi bí a ti jọ ń kà papọ̀ báyìí.
Hebrews chapter 7 verse 11. If therefore perfection were by the Levitical priesthood, for under it the people received the law, what further need was there that another priest should rise after the order of Melchizedek and not be called after the order of Aaron?
Nje iba se pe pipe nbe nipa oye alufa Levi nitori pe labe re ni awon eniyan gba ofin kini o si tun ku mo ti alufa miran iba fi dide nipa ese Mekisedeki
ya ko si
wi pe nipa ese Aroni.
Verse 12, for the priesthood being changed, there is made of necessity a change also of the law.
Ni ese ikejila nitori bi ati paro oye alufa a ko si le sai paro ofin pelu.
For he of whom these things are spoken pertaineth to another tribe, of which no man gave attendance at the altar.
Nitori eni ti an soro nkan woyi nipa re je iya miran latinu eyi ti eni keni ko ijosin ri nibi pepe.
For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood.
Nitori o han gbangba pe latinu eya Judah ni Oluwa wa ti dide nipa eya ti Moses ko so nko ni ti awon alufa.
And it is yet far more evident, for that after the similitude of Melchizedek, there ariseth another priest.
O si to han gbangba ju be lo bi o ti je pe alufa miran dide gege bi Melchizedeki,
who is made not after the law of a carnal of commandment, but after the power of an endless life.
Eyi ti a ko fi je gege bi ofin ilana nipa ti ara bi ko se nipa agbara ti iye ailopin.
For he testifies thou art a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek.
Nitori ajeri pe iwo ni alufa ti lai nipa ese Mekisedeki.
For there is verily it is annulling of the commandment going before for the weakness and unprofitableness thereof.
Nitori amu ofin saju kuro nitori ailera ati ailere re.
For the law made nothing perfect, but the bringing in of a better hope did, by the which we draw near unto God.
Nitori ofin ko mu onkohun pe a si mu ireti ti o dara ju wa nipa eyi ti a wa nso mo Olorun.
As we look at the passage we have read together,
bi a ti n wo bi ti a kae papo,
you will see there are two things that stand out very clearly.
Wa ri pe awon nkan meji o loduro gbangbe nbe.
Number one is talking about the priesthood and the things related to the priesthood.
Akoko o n so nipa oye alufa ati awon nkan to je mo oye alufa.
In verse 11, he mentions the Levitical priesthood.
Ni ese ikokanla o so nipa oye alufa.
In verse 12, it talks about the priesthood being changed. And then in verse 14, it's talking about something concerning priesthood. Verse 14. And then in verse 15, it's talking about the rising up of another priest. In verse 17, it's talking about thou art a priest after the order of
Melchizedek.
So number one, you will see that the passage is talking about the priesthood. If you are talking about the priesthood, you are talking about the function of the priest. And then there is a second point you find here. It's talking about a change. One coming before, another one coming after. Look at verse 12. For the priesthood being changed, there is made of necessity a change also of the law.
Nitori pe bi a ti paro oye alufa a ko si la a o le sai paro paro fin pelu.
It's telling us then there is an old covenant and there is a new covenant.
O so fun wa ni pe majemu lai lai wa majemu titun si wa.
And it's telling us that the things related to the old covenant will not be the things that are related to the new covenant.
O si so fun wa pe ohun ti o ni ajosepo pelu majemu lai lai ohun ko lo ma ni ajosepo pelu majemu titun.
Is therefore going to make a contrast and a comparison between the old and the new.
Nipa bayi yo wa fe se afiwe tabi afijo laarin majem lai lai ati tuntun.
And he must give us a reason why the old is being cast off and the new is being brought in.
O si lati so eredi re fun wa eti a fin lati gbagbe ti lai lai ti a si tun ma wo titun yi.
Look at verse 11.
Wo we se ikokanla.
If therefore perfection were by the Levitical priesthood, what further need was there of another priest?
O ni njẹ ibase pe pipe nbe ninipa oya alufa lefi kini o si to ku mo bi ti alufa miran miran yo
ba telling us then because the old covenant the old priesthood did not bring perfection that's why there is a change
it o so fun wa bi pe nitori pe oya alufa ti mo jem lai lai o mu pipe wa idin ni a fi lati paro
re and the bringing in of the new is to bring perfection
nigba ti a ba si mu ti to paro re iyen ni pe a mu pipe wonu re
look at verse 19
iwo we se ikokan
de lo law made nothing perfect.
Only nitori ofin ko mu ohunkohun
pe. He's still referring to the old covenant.
O si n talk as it maje mo lai
lai. I'm telling you that the God of perfection will not allow the old covenant to remain because the old covenant did not bring perfection.
O ni Olorun ti o je pipe ko ni fi aye gba maje mo lai lai lati tesiwaju tori pe o ko le mu ohun gbogbo pe.
He's looking for perfection.
O n wa nkan ti o pe.
He's looking for holiness.
O fe igbe aye wa
ni. He's looking for transparency.
O fe ti yo mo gara.
He's looking for a kind of worship that will not have any blemish.
O n wa iru isin ti o ni ni abawon kankan.
But the old covenant with the old priesthood could not bring in the perfection. Therefore he set aside the old covenant to bring in the new covenant which will bring the desired perfection.
Tori pe majemo lai lai ko le mu iru isin be itinu Olorun dun si wa. Tori na o lati party si egbe kan lati mu titun wa eti yo mu iru isin ti Olorun tewo gba wa.
That's why it says in verse 19 but the bringing in of a better hope did.
O ti to fi so ni ese ikokandinlogun ni pe a si mu ireti ti o dara ju wa.
So then you find the passage you were studying talking about the change from the old to the new.
Nipa bayi o wa ri pe ibi ti a tin keko loni o so nipa iyipada ninu kuro ninu ti lai lai ti tuntun.
You see the children of Israel they knew that if you are talking about religion you are talking about worship you are talking about prayer you cannot talk about those things without sacrifices and without the priest.
O ma awon ma Israeli won mo pe ti eyan ba nsoro nipa ijosin tabi nipa adura tabi nipa ohunkohun to je mo isin iru eni be ko le sai soro nipa iruba ati alufa.
And when you talk of the priesthood you are talking of the tribe of Levi.
Ti o ba si nsoro nipa oye alufa o so nipa awon eya Levi.
And they knew from the scripture Old Testament and they knew from experience that any priest that was coming will come after the order of Aaron and will come from the tribe of Levi.
Won si mo wi pe ti o ba nsoro nipa ti oye alufa ninu gege bi agbekale oro Olorun to ye won won mo pe en ti o ba joye olori alufa yo wa ni ipase Aaron.
But now he was telling them according to revelation of scripture that the old made nothing perfect.
O si wa nso fun won ni yi pe gege bi ifi oro Olorun pe ti majem lai lai ko mu ohun gbogbo.
So we need a change.
Tori na anilo yi pada.
We need a new covenant.
Anilo majem titun.
Immediately they are going to begin to think.
Loju ese ni wa bere si ni ronu.
If we need another covenant.
Pe ti a ba nilo majem titun.
How about the function of the priest?
Kini ti ipo ti awon alufa n gba
na. How about the priesthood?
Oye alufa nko.
How about the sacrifices?
Iruba nko nigba na.
And now he was telling them yes there is a new priest.
O wa so fun pe looto ni alufa tuntun mi wa.
And there is a new covenant.
Be si ni majem titun wa.
And there is a new priesthood.
Be si ni oye alufa tuntun wa.
From which tribe is that priest coming?
Ṣugbọn lati ẹyawo ni alufa na yo ti wa.
Because you know they were thinking every priest must come from the tribe of Levi.
Tori ko mo pe gbogbo won ma ronu pe gbogbo alufa ti o ba wa yo wa lati eya Levi.
But he told them that new priest is not from the tribe of Levi.
Ṣugbọn wa so fun pe alufa tuntun yi ko ni wa lati eya Levi.
Because his priesthood is after the order of Melchizedek.
Tori pe ise alufa re o wa ni ise ilana ti Melchizedek.
He's not talking about the supreme priest.
O si wa nso nipa ti alufa ti o ga julo.
With his provision.
Ati ipese re.
With his sacrifice.
Ati irubo re.
With the covenant.
Ati majemo re.
Very much superior to everything you find in the Old Testament.
Eti o gbegba oroke ju gbogbo eto le ri nu majemo lai lai.
And that's Jesus Christ that we're talking about.
Eleyi si ni Jesu Kristi en ti a nsoro nipa e.
Jesus the superior priest.
Jesu olori alufa ti o ga julo.
There are 3 points we're going to find out as we find as we touch on this passage.
Àwọn kókó mẹ́ta ni a ó gbàyẹ̀wò bí a ti ń wo àwọn ibi tí a kà yìí.
Number one, perfection unattainable under the old priesthood.
Àkọ́kọ́ ni ipò pípé tí a kò lè dé lábẹ́ oyè àlùfáà àti láéláé.
Understand that's the thing that made the change necessary.
Lóye eléyìí pé eléyìí ló mú kí ìyípadà náà ṣe pàtàkì.
Perfection unattainable under the old priesthood.
Ipò pípé tí a kò lè dé lábẹ́ oyè àlùfáà àti láéláé.
Number two, priest, the priest of the new covenant. covenant. The priest of the new covenant. Number three. Provision through our perfect priest. Let's look at number one. We're looking at verse 11 once again. If therefore perfection were by the Levitical priesthood, for under ye the people received the law, what further need was there that another priest should rise after the order of Melchizedek, and not to be called after the order of Aaron?
Kini o si tun ku mo ti alufa imiran ba fi dide nipa ese Melchizedek ti a ko si wi pe nipa ese Aaron.
The major point here is that perfection did not come through the Levitical priesthood.
Koko ti ala ti mo ni ni pe pipe ko wa nipa oye alufa ati Levi.
He's telling us if perfection had come through that avenue, there will be no change at all.
Oni o so fun wa pe to ba je pe pipe ti wa nipa ese oye alufa Levi ni ko ba ti si yi pada
rara. That is originally God intended that the Levitical priesthood was only for a time.
Tori pe lati ibere ni Olorun fun re ti gba lero pe o ya olufa ati awon Levi fun igba die ni.
It was not accidental that a change had to come.
Ki se pe boyo sesi pe iyipada yo de ba.
You who study the Old Testament, you need to understand.
Iwo ti eyin te nkeko nipa majem laile lati loye
eleyi. From Genesis chapter 3.
Ki pe ninu Genesis ori
the Lord that provided, the Lord that promised that the seed of the woman will come and bruise the head of the serpent.
Wi pe Oluwa ti seleri pe ru
and the seed of the woman is the Lord Jesus Christ, born of Virgin Mary. And so from the earliest time in the history of humanity, the Lord had decided, the God Father in heaven had decided that Jesus will come, and he it is that will bring redemption.
As far back as
Genesis,
we're
told that Shiloh will come, and to him shall be the gathering of the people. It wasn't accidental. God had known and God had purposed that Jesus Christ eventually will come. Even during the time of Moses, the Lord had made Moses to understand that the law was a temporary thing. He had said, a prophet will arise like unto you. I will put my word in his mouth. All the people will listen to him. All that was telling Moses that all this law now, all these sacrifices now, all the Levitical priesthood now is a temporary thing. The perfect was still to come. And it wasn't something accidental that he didn't come through Levi. His star shall arise from the tribe of Judah. Balaam had prophesied. He said the Lord had determined he will not change his mind. All the things we are doing now, they are symbolic and they are looking forward to the perfect one to come. And so if those Old Testament people had known, if they had looked at all the writings of the Old Testament properly, they would have known that the perfect one was still to come. Everything they were doing in their sacrifices, they were temporary. You found, as I quoted to you in Genesis, that Jesus was still the expected one. In the Pentateuch, in the Law, that is Exodus and Leviticus and Numbers and Deuteronomy, they were told that the perfect one was still to come.
As you
go to the time of the prophets, they were told. David was told that his son will come, he will reign upon the throne forever. That's why Jesus is referred to as the Son of David.
Ati so aso tele ye fun David tele pe a o bi omo kan ni idile re oni yo gori te re titi lai idini ti a fin pe Jesu ni iru omo David.
I fire made it very clear, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and you'll call his name Emmanuel, and his name will be Wonderful and Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, is a Prince of Peace. They knew that the perfect one was still to come. All they had in the Old Testament was temporary.
Isaiah tile so aso tele yi pe a bi omo kunrin kan Emmanuel la ku oruko re yo je iyanu Olorun alagbara baba yeraye omo alade alafia gbogbo awon ti won si nka aso tele yi ti mo pe ofin ati ilana ayeye irubo o wa fun igbara
npe ni. He was bruised for iniquities, the chastisement of our peace is upon him. He laid upon him the iniquity of us all. He was pointing to Christ that will come. When they read that, they should have known that the Levitical priesthood was a temporary thing. The perfect one was still to come.
Apalara nitori irekoja wa ana nitori yese wa inalafia wa nbe lara re gbogbo awon akosile ta ti ko yi o ntoka si Jesu Kristi eyi si mu da won loju pe gbogbo ilana ofin ati ayeye isin won igba na o wa fun igba die nitori pe Jesu pipe yo si wa.
The problem with the children of Israel that they have been given the old covenant, a temporary thing, and they have been told that the perfect one was still to come. They were blind to the perfect one. They were blind to the thing to still come in the future. And they glued themselves on the old covenant. That's the problem they had when Jesus came, and they didn't receive Jesus Christ. But perfection did not come through that old covenant.
Ele ti ati so aso tele re ninu majem lai lai ti ati si je ko di mimo fun won pe o nbo nigba to de nitori pe won ti so ara won po mo ilana ofin ati ayeye isin nigba to de won o gba idigan niyan to fi je pe won wa ninu wahala sugbon sibe sibe oko si ilana pipe ninu gbogbo ilana isin won ni igba na.
That's why we were in the new covenant now. We don't go back into the sacrificing of animals. Because you see, there are some denominations and churches.
So
you say, well, but we read it in the Bible that the people of God, the Israelites, they were killing animals. We say, yes, it was temporary. It was a time of imperfection. Christ, the perfect one, has come. All those sacrifices are now out of the way. Christ, the perfect sacrifice, and the perfect priest has come. We abandon the old, we hold on to the new.
Aso pe be ni idi ti a fi se be ni pe Christ o ti de nigba na sugbon ni bayi Christ ti wa en ti se ni pipe an lati pa gbogbo ti mo yemu lai lai ti ki a wa wa sinu pipe bayi.
They tell us, but we read in the Old Testament that Moses was told to remove his shoes. Why don't we remove our shoes today? We tell them that's the old covenant. That's in the Old Testament, and that was a time of imperfection, incompleteness, insufficiency, inadequacy. But the adequate one, the sufficient one, the perfect one has now arrived, and now we don't worship with the outward, removing shoe, not wearing shoe. We don't worship the Lord in spirit and in
truth. Ni akoko mojem lai lai niyan sele sugbon ni bayi Christi Oluwa ti wa o ni pipe o ni apere ku ati lati tele tori na Olorun o bere ru lana yen lowo wa mo.
They tell us, don't you read in the Old Testament that the priest was to come and the priest burnt incense before the Lord?
I wa so fun wa pe e wa ka ninu mojem lai lai ni pe ngba yi awon alufa awon ma sun tura re ni waju pepe.
So they tell us they are trying to follow the Bible.
Wa wa so fun pe awon na ngbiyanju lati tele ti
be ni. We tell them that was a time of imperfection.
An so fun pe
that at that time they burnt incense. But now the time of imperfection has gone. The perfect sacrifice, the perfect priest has come. We do not stay in those Old Testament rituals anymore. We now worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. No candle, no incense, and all those things.
Lai mo
also tell us that we do not make the priesthood today very dignifying. Because they look at the priesthood of Aaron. And they look at the detail of the garment and the thing that Aaron as a priest will have to wear. And so they say today, if you are going to give the dignity to the office of the preacher and the bishop and the priest, you will close the priest of today like Aaron of the past was closed. And then we tell them the reason we don't do that is because that's the old priesthood. The new priesthood, the priesthood of Christ, is not on the special dressing of the bishop, because Jesus Christ did not have any special dressing. He just dressed anyhow. The thing that marks him out as a new priest is the anointing that breaks the yoke, because he was anointed with the Holy Ghost and with power. He went about doing good, he did not to oppress of the devil, for God was with him. It is the anointing, the power, the holiness, the sanctity, the purity that marks him out today. It is not the priesthood of the Old Testament.
You see the problem
is that perfection will never come if you are sticking on to the old covenant and to the old priesthood. If you want to move on to perfection, if you want to be in the direct presence of God, if you want to go beyond the experiences of the old covenant people, if you want to follow the Lord Jesus Christ, the superior priest, you will abandon the old, you will embrace the new. In Hebrews chapter 8 verse 7, for if the first covenant had been faultless, then should no place have been sought for the second.
Nítorí ìbáṣe pé májẹ̀mú ìṣáájú kò ní àbùkù, ǹjẹ́ àkìbá tí wáyé fún èkejì.
You see now that the first commandment, the old covenant, it had some faults, it had some weakness. The weakness is that he could not make the people that were coming through that avenue, it could not make them perfect. That's why the second, the new, the better one, the higher one, that's why it has now come to replace it.
O lè rí pé májẹ̀mú láéláé, májẹ̀mú ìṣáájú ni. O ní àbùkù, torí pé kò lè sọ àwọn ènìyàn tí wọ́n ń tipasẹ̀ rẹ̀ wá síwájú Ọlọ́run di pípé. Ìdí tí a ti láti pátì sí ẹgbẹ́ kan tí a sì láti wáyè fún tuntun nìyí.
Acts chapter 13 verse 39.
Ìṣe àwọn apostẹ́lì orí kẹtàlá ẹsẹ̀ ìkọkàndínlógójì.
Acts chapter 13.
Ìṣe àwọn apostẹ́lì orí kẹtàlá.
Let us read from verse 38.
Ẹjẹ́ àkà láti ẹsẹ̀ ìkejìdínlógójì.
Be known unto you therefore, men and brethren, that through this man, as Jesus Christ, is preached unto you the forgiveness of sin.
Ǹjẹ́ kí ó yé yín ara pé nípasẹ̀ ọkùnrin ìyẹn ni Jésù Kristì yìí lè àwọn wàásù ìdáríjì ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ fún yín.
And by him, that is by Jesus Christ, all that believe are justified from all things, listen to this, from which ye could not be justified by the law of Moses.
Ó ní àti nípa rẹ̀ yẹn ni pé àti nípasẹ̀ Jésù Kristì ni à ń dá olúkúlùkù ẹni tí ó gbàgbọ́ láre kúrò nínú ohun gbogbo ìwọ fetí sí eléyìí tí a kò lè dá yín láre nínú òfin Mose.
Oh, he said, you see the shortcoming of the old covenant.
Ó wá rí ìkùnà ti májẹ̀mú láéláé báyìí.
You see the weakness of the old priesthood.
Ó wá rí àìlera oyè àlùfáà àti májẹ̀mú láéláé.
You see the inadequacy, insufficiency of the old law and the old priesthood.
Ó wá rí àìtó àti àìpé tó wà nínú òfin àtijọ́ àti
ilé ayé. You see, your sin at that time could be covered, but it could not be totally cleansed away.
Ó jẹ́ mẹ́ pé ní ìgbà ni a lè bu ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ rẹ mọ́lẹ̀ ṣùgbọ́n a kò lè wẹ̀ nu mọ́ kúrò.
You see, you could be pardoned, but you could not be perfected.
O lè rí pé ngbà náà a lè darí rẹ̀ jẹ́ ṣùgbọ́n a ò lè sọ ọ́ di pípé.
Now you must understand. understand. There were people in the Old Testament Old Covenant that lived pure. You talk about Samuel. You talk about Daniel. You talk about Job. But you understand, those were special people, those were exceptional people. It's the same thing with Enoch that was raptured. The rapture was not for everybody at that time. At the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, millions of Christians will be raptured. What is reserved for the millions in the church age was only for Enoch and Elijah in the Old Covenant. So there were people in the Old Covenant that went beyond their covenant and went beyond their priesthood, and they were able to grab the thing that is for the coming age, but they were very, very few. But the generality of the people did not have the thing that now is available for the church.
But you see, in the general,
it was not made available to everybody at that time. Because it is especially for the people in the New Covenant.
In
Romans chapter 3, reading from verses 20 and 21,
it
says, therefore by the deeds of the law there shall no man be justified in his sight, for by the law is the knowledge of sin.
It
says, but now can you see he's now going to make a comparison. He has told you in verse 20, if you were just in the Old Covenant, by the deeds of the law, by the knowledge of the law, no man shall be fully justified in his sight.
There
it says, but now the righteousness of God without the law is manifested, being witnessed by the law and the prophet. In Galatians chapter 2 verse 21. Galatians chapter 2 verse 21. I do not frustrate the grace of God, for if righteousness come by the law, then Christ is dead in vain. Can you see there is telling us that full righteousness, perfect righteousness, transparent righteousness, uninterrupted righteousness could not have come by the Old Testament covenant, or by the old priesthood, or by the old law? It means that the old covenant was not sufficient. It was not the ultimate. It was not the final. But the new covenant, the new testament, the new priesthood was still to come. That will be the supreme, that will be the final, that will be the climax, the conclusion of everything. In Romans chapter 8 and verse
3.
Romans chapter 8 verse
3.
It says, for what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh, God sending his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin condemned sin in the flesh.
Oni nitori ohun ti ofin ko le se bi o si je alailera nitori ara
Olorun ran omo ohun ti kara re ni aworan ara ese ati bi ebo fun ese o si da ese lebi ninu ara.
That means if we had remained all in the old covenant.
Iye tumo se pe ti o ba je pe ninu mejem laila la ka joko si.
There are some spiritual heights we never have reached.
Awon ilepa ti emi kan wa ti a o le
ebe. There are some spiritual victories we never have got.
Awon isegun ti emi kan wa ti abati ri gba.
We would not have been more than conquerors like we could be now under the new covenant.
A o le ju asegun lo iru eta je loni.
That's why the Lord had to brush aside the old covenant so that the new covenant will come in. That's why the believer today will not plunge his head in the old covenant, in the old sacrifices, old priesthood again. There are people that don't understand this. And they still follow after the Sabbath. And they still follow after sacrifices. And they still follow after the system of worship of the old covenant. The dressing of the priesthood of the old covenant. The carrying of this and carrying of that and filing up and lining up like the old covenant. The burning of incense, the burning of candle, the burning of a dish. And that like in the old covenant. In fact, there are some that are still keeping the Passover like in the old covenant. And there are people that are still visiting Jerusalem and going to the holy place and visiting Bethlehem and all that like they are still back in the time you are in the old covenant. But now we're told we have been brought to the new covenant. In Hebrews chapter 10, reading from verse 1,
it's
very important for the understanding of the believer. For the law, having a shadow of good things to come, not the very image of the sins, can never with those sacrifices with the which they offer year by year continually make the commerce thereunto perfect.
Oni nitori ofin bi o ti ni awojiji awon orere tin bo lai je aworan aworan papa awon nkan na won ko le fi ebo kan na ti won ru nigba gbogbo ni ododun mu awon ti nwa sibe di pipe.
Can you see it says can never?
Oni won ko le.
It can never make those people that are coming through the old covenant of a new, it will never make them perfect.
Oni ko le sese fun awon eniyan to je pe iru iri majem laila ni an gbe wonu titun ko le mu kan ko di pipe.
Yeah, that's the reason why you're now in the new covenant.
Idigan ni ta fi wa nu majem titun.
Hey, look at verse 4.
Wo wo ese ikere.
For it is not possible that the blood of bulls and of goats should take away sins.
Oni nitori ko sese fun eje ako malu ati ti ewure lati mu ese kuro.
What that means says that although they dealt with sin,
entele tumo si ni pe bo tile je pe won yanju isoro
ese. But you see, they have to be dealing with sin every year, every time.
Ngbon won lati ma yanju re lododun ati ngba gbogbo.
But now the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all unrighteousness.
Ngbon ni sin eje Jesu o nwe wa nu kuro na ese.
Now the seed of God abides in the believer and he cannot sin because he's born of God. Now for the new creature, all things are passed away. All things have become new. Now we do not need somebody to be making sacrifice for us in Shiloh or Jerusalem, in your room, in this place, any other place, whosoever. Ever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. It is not something physical now. It is not something you are laying your hand upon an animal. You look by faith at the Lord, and then as you believe, all your sins are taken away.
Nibai, You
have now understood the reason why the old had been set aside and the new has been brought in. Because perfection could not come through that avenue. Let's go to point number two. The priest of the new covenant. As you look at the new covenant, everything is new. Everything is different. Now perfection is possible. Coming to the very presence of God is possible. Being called the children of God, that is possible. The Spirit of God coming into everyone, that is not possible. He now lives within us and walks within us. That's the possibility in the new covenant. And the priest of the new covenant is not a faulty human being, is the perfect Son of God, Jesus Christ. Look at it from verse 12. For the priesthood being changed, there is made of necessity a change also of the law. Now he's talking about now there's going to be a change of the law. When you read about the law in the sense of the old covenant, you need to understand. The law was very, very broad. Sometimes you read in the Bible, it says the law and the prophets. Sometimes it says the law, the prophets, and the psalms. You see, whenever they mention the law in particular, the law itself had some distinctions, departments, divisions.
There is
the law of sacrifices. There is a civil law. That is the law that relates with one man to the other, one man to his neighbor, one family to the other. And then there is the moral law. As you look at the word of God, I think I've shared it with you before, that the sacrificial system, referred to as the law, all that has been abandoned, all that has been changed. But the moral law, that one has been preserved and renewed. So that when it says the law has been changed, you will understand what that is saying. It's telling you that the sacrificial law that has been changed.
How
about the moral law? Thou shalt have no other gods before me. In the New Testament, what does it say? Children, keep yourself away from idols. How about the second commandment? When it says that you will not make any image, you will not bow down to them, you will not worship them. What does the New Testament say? There is one Lord and God, the Father of us all. And the time has now come, you'll worship him in spirit and in truth, for the Father seeketh us to worship him. What's the third moral law? It says you will not call the name of the Lord in vain. What does the New Testament say? At the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Then it says, number four, you will remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. New Testament, forsake not the assembling of ourselves together. And then it says, honor your father, honor your mother, that your days may be long on the earth when the Lord has given you. Children, New Testament, now children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right, for this is the first commandment with promise. And then it says in the Old Testament, thou shalt not kill. What does the New Testament say? You have heard in the Old, it says thou shalt not kill, but now I say unto you that if you are angry with your brother without a cause, thou shalt be in danger of judgment. If you say raka or doubtful, you'll be in the danger of hellfire.
Only what you got be as you call no majam like way walk of God of Pania. Only super mo we fun yipe ni any kind of bad binu si arakun re lasan tabi what to back arakun red ni raka tabuto kweni as you were wa le wa.
And he says thou shall not steal.
Only walk of God of Jali.
What does the New Testament say?
Ni no majam to kilo
a we says let him that stole steal no more.
Only anything jale kyo ma se jale.
But let him walk with his hands the things that are good, that he may have to give to the people that are in need. And then it says you will not be a false witness. And the New Testament it says speak the truth everyone with his neighbor, for you are put off the old man and you are put on the new man. He says thou shalt not covet anything that belongs to a neighbor, his wife, his whatever he has, his ass, his servant. You will not covet anything that belongs to your neighbor. What does it say in the New Testament? Mortify your members that are on the earth. And then he mentions them, and at last says covetousness, which is idolatry. So when it says there is a change of priesthood and there is a change of the law, he's talking about the sacrificial system of the law. The moral law is still there. You will still not steal, you will not commit adultery, you will not do anything that is evil like that, because in the New Testament you are to live a holy life, a righteous life, a perfect life.
And
so in verse 12, for the priesthood being changed, there is a necessity, there is made a necessity of necessity, a change of the law.
Why don't we
follow the sacrificial system of the law anymore? Because Christ, our Passover lamb, is sacrificed for us. Behold the lamp of God that takes away the sin of the world. Because you have not been redeemed by the blood of animals, but by the blood of Jesus Christ, as of his spotless perfect lamb.
Tori pe a ko ti pase eje wure tabi ako malu rayi pada bi ko se nipase eje odo aguta eti o je pipe to je alailabuku.
So that's why we don't offer animal sacrifices today.
Idi ti a ki fin fi eran rubo mo ni
in verse 13.
Ni ese iketala.
For he of whom these things are spoken pertained to another tribe, of which no man gave attendance at the altar.
Nitori eni ti a soro nkan wo yi nipa re je iya miran lati nu eyi ti eni
he's telling us that the priesthood of the Old Testament had to come from the tribe of Levi. But the person we're talking about now, Jesus Christ, from David, is from the tribe of Judah. That's why it's referred to as the of the tribe of David, and then it says the lion of the tribe of where? Judah. In verse 14, for it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood.
Ni
nipa eya ti Mose ko so nko ni ti awon alufa.
That Jesus is telling us that Moses talking about the priesthood, he was talking of the priesthood of the old covenant, and the priesthood of the old covenant was from the tribe of Levi, and yet you can see that the new priesthood is coming from the tribe of Judah.
O so fun wa pe nigba ti Mose nsoro nipa ti oye alufa ko so nipa eya abomiran bi ko se pe lati eya Levi sugba oye alufa ti Christi lati eya Juda ni.
In verse 15, and it is yet far more evident, for that after the similitude of Melchizedek there ariseth another priest.
Ni ese ike edogun o si tun han gbangba ju be lo bi o ti je pe alufa miran dide gege bi Melchizedek.
I already shared that with you last week, that he was both priest and king. The priesthood of a Levi was limited and temporary. It was limited to the land of Israel. And it was temporary, just for a period, until the Son of God, Jesus Christ, will come and then bring an end to the old covenant. And also the priesthood of the Levites could not bring him permanent, uninterrupted holiness and perfection. But in the case of Jesus Christ, he brought in both holiness and perfection. And then he's also royal, is eternal. And so in verse 16, who is made not after the law of a carnal commandment, but after the power of an endless
life.
He's talking about the fact that all the priests of the Old Testament, they'll be priests now, then they die, another priest will come, then he dies, another priest will come, then he dies. But these new priests, the priests of the new covenant, he liveth forever.
On so ni ipe nipa ti oye alufa ti majemo lai lai alufa kan yo je yo ku imi o tun je yo tun ku elomi o tun je yo ku sugba nipa ti Christi o je o en to je oye alufa ti o si wa titi lai.
In verse 17, for he testified, thou art a priest forever. Not somebody will take over, not that he will die and is no more a priest, he is a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek.
Ni ese iketadilogun nitori ajeri pe iwo ni alufa titi lai, iyen ni pe ko si en ti yo ropo re, ki se pe boya yo ku elomi o gba po re sugba o je alufa titi lai nipa ese Melchizedek.
Once again, let us remind ourselves that the Old Testament people should have known that God said he was bringing in a new covenant.
Le kan si e je ki ara ara wa leti pe awon eniyan nu majemu lai lai won lati ranti pe oluwa ti so pe yo majemu titun wa.
You see, their problem is they were ignorant of the scriptures.
Sugba wahala ti won ni pe won ya oko si iwe mimo.
That's why they were fighting Jesus every time, because Jesus came and was changing everything, and everything was totally different. He healed on the Sabbath day, he didn't keep their ceremonial laws, and because of that they were quarreling with him. They didn't know that the old covenant was to be rolled up and stored away, the new covenant was to take his place. They didn't treat their Old Testament very well. That's why they were fighting the law. Look at Jeremiah chapter 31. Telling us that the new will come. The old will be pushed aside. Jeremiah 31 from verse 31. Behold, the days come, says the Lord, that I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah.
Wo ojo nbo ni Oluwa wi ti emi o ba ile Israeli ati ile Juda damaje mu tutun.
Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the days that I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, which my covenant did break, although I was an husband unto them, says the Lord.
Ki se bi maje mu na ti emi ba baba won da ni ojo na ti emi fa won lowo lati mu won jade lati ile Egypt awon ti won da maje mu mi bi emi tile je alakoso won sibe.
Verse 33, but this shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law in their inward parts and write it in their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people.
Sugbon eyi ni majemu ti emi o ba ile Israeli da leyin ojo won ni Oluwa wi emi o fi ofin mi si inu won emi o si ko si aya won emi o si je Olorun won won o si je eniyan mi.
Look at Hebrews chapter 8.
Wowo Eberu orikejo.
And in verse 13.
Ese iketala.
Hebrews chapter 8 verse 13.
Eberu orikejo ese iketala.
In that he says, a new covenant he makes the first old. Now, that which decays and waxeth old is ready to vanish away.
Ni eyi ti o wi pe majemu titun ti o ti so ti saju di ti lailai sugbon eyi ti o di ti lailai ti o si ngbo o mura ati di aso.
Now you can see that he was getting rid of the old so that he can bring in the new.
O wa le ri pe o fagile ti lailai lati le mu titun wa.
And so the children of Israel should have understood.
Nipa ba awon mo Israeli lati lo
that the old was to pass away and the new was to come. And that Jesus Christ says the priest of the new covenant. We now come to point number 3. The provision through a perfect priest. Already you have seen now that the old is gone and the new was coming. And this is what the apostle was trying to emphasize and impress upon the Jewish people of that time, that they shouldn't rest their salvation on the circumcision, on the Levitical priesthood, on the sacrificial system, on the old Mosaic law, on the temple synagogue. But now they shall come on to the new covenant and put their faith and their trust in the Lord Jesus Christ.
I
know that the perfect has come, the imperfect has gone away. Look at now chapter 7 of Hebrews from verse 18 to verse
19.
For there is verily a disannulling of the commandment going before for the weakness and unprofitableness thereof.
Nítorí a mú òfin ìsáájú kúrò nítorí àìlera àti àìlérè rẹ̀.
There is a disannulling.
Àti fagilé.
There is a removal.
Àti mú kúrò.
There is a cancellation.
Àti
there is a forgetting and the burial of the old so that the new can rise up.
As you
come and you worship, and as you pray, check up your worship, check up your prayer life and your prayer style. And you see there are people that are not born again, but they are coming from the background of the people that were immersed in the Old Testament system. Before you
are
born again, you are going to a particular assembly, to a particular congregation. And there were things they were doing there. Those things were patterned after the old covenant. And you see now you are born again. You have come over here. And when you see the way that we worship here, it may be that you have been wondering, why don't they burn candle? Why don't they burn incense? Why don't they bow down when they mention the name of Jesus? Why don't they remove their shoes? Why don't they make the sign of the cross? Why don't they make the visible things the real thing, and then they just talk about the outward thing, the external thing, the sign and the symbol and all those things? Why are you all sitting together? And they don't make the men to sit on that side and the women to sit on that side. What do they allow those women that are having their period? What do they allow them to sit inside the church building? Why don't they tell them that if you're having your period, please sit outside? And then you are still wondering, and maybe you are a Christian, a believer already, but at a particular time you will not come. And we say, why don't you come? You say, well, it's between me and God. Because where I was before, when you are in this condition, you cannot come into the church building. All that is the old covenant. Come and long unto the new covenant, and come in the worship in spirit and in truth.
He's telling us
that all those old covenant, old testament things, they are passed away. Now you are in the new covenant. In verse 19, made nothing perfect, but the bringing in of a better hope did, by the which we draw near unto God.
Nítorí òfin kò mú ohunkóhun pé a sì mú ìrètí tí ó dára jù wá nípa èyí tí àwa ń súnmọ́ Ọlọ́run.
Hebrews chapter 8 verse 10.
Hebrews oríkẹjọ ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹwàá.
For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my laws into their mind and write them in their heart. I will be to them a God, and they shall be to me a people.
Nítorí èyí ni májẹ̀mú tí èmi ó ba ilé Israẹli dá lẹ́yìn ọjọ́ wọn ni Olúwa wí. Èmi ó fi òfin mi sínú wọn, èmi ó sì kọ wọn sí ọkàn wọn, èmi ó sì máa jẹ́ Ọlọ́run fún wọn, wọn ó sì máa jẹ́ ènìyàn fún mi.
Christ has made everything new now.
Christ ti sọ ohun gbogbo di ọ̀tún báyìí.
He has cleansed us, he has washed us.
Ó ti wẹ̀ wá mọ́, ó ti sọ wá di mímọ́.
And the law of God is written upon our heart.
Òfin Ọlọ́run akọ sínú ọkàn àyà wa
báyìí. He makes us to know it's not just that we're trying to keep the law externally, even the spirit of the law.
Ó wá jẹ́ ká mọ̀ nísìnyí pé kì í kàn ṣe pé bóyá à ń pa òfin mọ́.
You know that the new is much, much higher than the old. In the old it says you will not commit adultery. In the new covenant it says if you look on a woman to lust after her, although you don't touch her, although you don't have any moral relationship with her, because of that immoral look you've committed adultery with her already in your heart.
To si ni okan lati ba se fe ku fe bo le je ko fowo ko obirin yen sugbon o ti ba dese pa saga
ni. In the old covenant it says you will not worship idol.
Ninu majem la la oni iwo ko gbodo bori sa.
In the new covenant it tells you that money can be your idol because of the love of money is the root of all evil.
Sugbon ninu majem titun o so fun wa pe owo le je orisa re tori pe ife owo ni gbongbo buburu gbogbo.
In the old covenant it says that you will not kill.
Ninu majem la la oni iwo ko gbodo pa
aya. In the new covenant it says he that hateth his brother in his heart is a murderer.
Ni ṣugbọn ninu majemu titun o ni enke to ba korira arakunrin re ninu okan re iru eni be je apaniyan.
So you see now the new covenant is a higher, better, richer, greater covenant.
O wa le ri bayi pe majemu titun o ga o je ti o loro ti o si dara lopolopo.
In Galatians chapter 2 verse 16.
Ninu Galatia orikeji ese ikerindelogun.
Galatians chapter 2 verse 16.
Galatia orikeji ese ikerindelogun.
Knowing that a man is not justified by the works of the law, but by faith, or by the faith of Jesus Christ, even we have believed in Jesus Christ, that we may be justified by the faith of Christ, not by the works of the law. For by the works of the law shall no flesh be justified.
See,
ẹnikẹni láre nípa iṣẹ́ òfin bí kò se nípa ìgbàgbọ́ nínú Jésù Kristi àní àwa náà gba Jésù Kristi gbọ́ kí a bá lè dá wa láre nípa ìgbàgbọ́ ti Kristi kì í sì ṣe nípa iṣẹ́ òfin nítorí pé nípa iṣẹ́ òfin kò sí ènìyàn kan tí a ó dá láre.
To bring everything to a conclusion, the blessings of the new covenant, those blessings are far greater.
Ká lè mú ohun gbogbo wá sí àṣekágbá, a ó rí pé ìbùkún ti ń bẹ́nu mọ́jẹ̀mú títo ó pọ̀lọ́pọ̀lọpọ̀.
In Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3.
Nínú Éfésù orí kìíní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹta.
Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3.
Éfésù orí kìíní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹta.
Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ.
Olùbùkún ni Ọlọ́run àti Bàbá Jésù Kristi Olúwa wa, ẹni tí ó ti fi gbogbo ìbùkún ẹ̀mí nínú àwọn ọ̀run bùkún wa nínú Kristi.
Go beyond the old covenant.
Ré kọjá kúrò nínú mọ́jẹ̀mú
láéláé. Salvation is now available in Christ.
Ìgbàlà ó ń bẹ nínú Kristi
báyìí. Come out of the old covenant.
Jáde kúrò nínú mọ́jẹ̀mú láéláé.
Sanctification, holiness, Christian perfection are now available in Christ.
Ìsọdi mímọ́ ìgbé ayé ìwà mímọ́ ó ti wà ní àrọ́wọ́tó nínú Kristi
báyìí. Come out of the old covenant.
Jáde kúrò nínú mọ́jẹ̀mú láéláé.
Only very few of them were saturated and beloved and filled with the Holy Ghost in the old covenant.
Àwọn èèyàn kéréje ọlá fi agbára ìmọ́kún nínú mọ́jẹ̀mú láéláé.
But after all that is after the old covenant to the new covenant, after what I'll pour my spirit upon all flesh.
Ṣùgbọ́n ní ìkẹyìn ìyẹn ni pé lẹ́yìn ìgbà tá a bá ti ré kọjá mọ́jẹ̀mú láéláé, òun mọ́ da ẹ̀mí mi sí ara ènìyàn
gbogbo. And then your sons and your daughters will prophesy, your old men will dream dreams.
Àwọn ọmọkùnrin àìtọ́ ọmọbìnrin yóò máa sọ àsọtẹ́lẹ̀, àwọn arúgbó yóò máa láàlá.
Upon the servants, upon the handmaids will I pour my spirit upon in those days.
Lórí àwọn ìránṣẹ́kùnrin àti ìránṣẹ́bìnrin èmi ó da ẹ̀mí mi lé lórí ní ọjọ́ wọn.
It's a new covenant.
Eléyìí ni mọ́jẹ̀mú titun.
In the new covenant, he promises you healing too.
Nínú mọ́jẹ̀mú titun ó ṣèlérí ìwòsàn.
I wish above all things that your soul will prosper, even as your spirit prospers, and then that you will be in health.
Èmi ń fẹ́ nígbà gbogbo pé kí o máa dára fún ọ, kí o sì lè wà ní ìlera àní bí o ti dára fún ọkàn rẹ.
In the new covenant, we cannot tell all the blessings that come to the believer.
Nínú mọ́jẹ̀mú titun àkàkà tó ni àwọn ìbùkún tó ń wá sínú ayé onígbàgbọ́.
Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20.
Éfésù orí kẹta ẹsẹ̀ ogún.
Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us.
Ǹjẹ́ ẹni tí ó lè ṣe lọ́pọ̀lọpọ̀ ju gbogbo èyí tí à ń béèrè tàbí tí à ń rò lọ gẹ́gẹ́ bí agbára tí ń ṣiṣẹ́ nínú wa?
The new covenant is full of blessing.
Nínú mọ́jẹ̀mú ti tó kún fún ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ìbùkún.
And the new covenant, you don't have to get to Jerusalem to get the blessing.
Nínú mọ́jẹ̀mú ti tó wà yóò nílò láti lọ sí Jerusalem
kó tó bá ìbùkún náà. You don't have to go to river Jordan and dip yourself inside there before you get the blessing.
O nílò láti lọ wẹ̀ nú odò Jordan kó tó gbà ìbùkún Ọlọ́run
báyìí. You need to wait for the day of atonement before your sins are atoned for.
O nílò láti dúró de ọjọ́ kan tá a yàsọ́tọ̀ fún ìwẹ̀nùmọ́ kó tó gbà ìwẹ̀nùmọ́.
You don't need any special day, any special time, any special dress, facing the east or facing the west or the north or the south before you get the blessing of the Lord.
O nílò láti wọ aṣọ abàmì kan tàbí aṣọ mẹ́rìnrí kan kó tó gbà ìbùkún Ọlọ́run tàbí kó kọjú sí ìhà ọ̀run ilé ìwọ̀ ọ̀run tàbí gúúsù tàbí àríwá kó tó gbà ìbùkún Ọlọ́run.
All things are now available for you through Christ in the new covenant.
Gbogbo nǹkan ló wà ní àrọ́wọ́tó fún ọ nípasẹ̀ Kristi nínú
ẹ̀jẹ̀ Romans chapter 8 and verse 32.
Nínú Rómù orí kẹjọ ẹsẹ̀ ìkejìlélọ́gbọ̀n.
Romans chapter 8 verse 32.
Rómù orí kẹjọ ẹsẹ̀ ìkejìlélọ́gbọ̀n.
He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things?
Ẹni tí kò dá ọmọ ohun tìkára rẹ̀ sí, ṣùgbọ́n tí ó jọ̀wọ́ rẹ̀ lọ́wọ́ fún gbogbo wa, yóò àti ṣe tí kì yóò fún wa ní ohun gbogbo pẹ̀lú rẹ̀ lọ́fẹ̀ẹ́.
All things are now ready. They were not ready in the Old Testament time, but now coming, all things are now ready.
Gbogbo nǹkan ló wà ní àrọ́wọ́tó báyìí, kò sí bẹ́ẹ̀ ní, kò sáǹfààní ẹnu mọ́jẹ̀mú láíláí, ṣùgbọ́n ní ìsìn ó ti wà ní àrọ́wọ́tó.
Whatsoever now you ask in the name of Jesus, I will give unto you, that the Father may be glorified in the Son.
Ohunkóhun tó o bá béèrè ní orúkọ Jésù, wọn ò fi fún ọ kí kábàlẹ̀yìn bàbá lógo nínú ọmọ.
Abandon the old, embrace the new.
Kọ mọ́jẹ̀mú láéláé sílẹ̀ kó o sì gbá mọ́jẹ̀mú
sí ọ̀rọ̀. Let's rise up and pray and talk to the Lord.
Ẹ jẹ́ ká dìde dúró ká gbàdúrà ká bá
olùsọ̀rọ̀. Look at the wonderful privilege you have in the new covenant.
Ẹ̀yin ẹ worú àwọn àǹfààní àgbàyanu tá a nínú
mọ́jẹ̀mú sí ọ̀rọ̀. Christ is our perfect priest.
Kristi ó ní àlùfáà wa
pípé náà. He died for us on the cross of Calvary.
Ó kú fún wa lórí igi àgbélébùú
Calvary. Remove all those Old Testament things from your worship.
Mú gbogbo àwọn àṣà mọ́jẹ̀mú láéláé kúrò nínú ìjọsìn rẹ.
Killing goat and killing ram and killing animal cry Christ, our Passover lamb, has died for us.
Kama pa ewure, kama pa go, kama pa gutan. Gbogbo ru awon kan ye ka mu kuro Christi, o ti ku fun wa.
Salvation is now available.
Igbala wa ni
awon. Whosoever will come to the Lord shall be saved. Call on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Eni kani ti o ba ke pe oruko Oluwa ni agbala.
Come, today is the day of salvation.
Ma bo loni oni
yo gbala. He will take your sins away.
Yo mu ese re
kuro. He will cleanse you.
Yo we omo.
As if you never sinned before in your life.
And
then there is a promise of sanctification. The God of peace shall sanctify you wholly. Your whole spirit, your whole body, your whole mind. He said that he will even preserve you blameless until the coming day. And then he says you will receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promises unto you and to your children and to them that far off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call.
He says,
now today, if you will believe, all things are possible for him that believeth. He says, healing is now the children's bread. Deliverance is now the children's bread. And you don't have to travel to Jerusalem to have anything from the Lord. You will hold on to the promises of the Lord. You will call upon the Lord, and the Lord will answer you. Today, the name of Jesus can be in your mouth. And anywhere you are, in your closet, in your room, in the office, in the house, in the church, when you call on the name of the Lord, he says he will answer you. Are you still killing animals? Are you still sacrificing? You are plunging yourself into the imperfect, insufficient, inadequate. Why not leave all those things and come to the perfect one?
Come
to the Lord today. And the Lord says he will give that which is perfect. Everything you couldn't have beyond the old covenant, you couldn't have in the Old Testament, he will give you now that you are in the New Testament. Now he will give us all things. Now he will bless you with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus.
Lay hold on
the promises of God. They will never fail. And you see, Jesus is by the right hand of the Father. Now he is praying for you, making intercession for you. Abandon the old, embrace the new.